V103 ATL's number one for hip-hop, R&B, and throwbacks. I told you he was going to be in the studio. Young.
What up, though? What's happening, my guy?
Jay Jenkins.
J-Jeezy Jenkins. In the building.
Adversity for sale.
Out everywhere books are sold right now, and if you're asking,
you gotta believe.
You gotta believe, and I did the audio book myself. So when you hear the audio book and you order it, matter of fact, go ahead and download your copy now.
You download the audio book?
Yes.
Download the audio book right now. Young Jeezy, Adversity for Sale. After all these years, albums, tours,
right.
Clothing line,
shoes. Yeah.
The book.
Yeah. It was time though. It was time, man. You know, it's just like you can't put all these stories in songs no more. You got to step it up. And I just had a lot of time to really, like, sit down and live with all this stuff. And I just wanted to put it in book form. So you get Jay, Jeezy, and Mr. Jenkins in one stop.
All of it.
All of it.
And while you reading the book, if you are of age, you can get your sip on.
You feel me? Some Nard.
Jeezy got something for you to sip on.
Yes, sir. Nard Cognac.
You still doing the Avion?
No. I sold my shares in that. I went on to Nard Spirits. So we got Cognac, we got vodka, we got gin.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you, brother.
Now, last night at the bank, the conversation with Jeezy.
Tip.
Hosted by Tip.
Yes, sir.
Was a movie in there.
No, it was good, man. It was like the vibe was crazy. Shout out to Naeem and HC99, the whole team. The vibe was great. Shout out to the bank. Shout out to Will and everybody over there on over Bankhead. The vibe was good, man. Like the vibe, you know.
It wasn't too many people.
Nah.
You know what I'm saying? It was just enough.
Yeah, you know,
it was a lot of people.
You know, Tip is hilarious, by the way.
Oh, Tip crazy.
Oh, he's crazy.
My phone started blowing up when y'all started talking about me. That's why I came over there. Yeah, D. Haynes was texting like, they talking about you.
Yeah, shout out to Greg Street. He was the first one to told me I should be selling the snowman shirts. Yeah.
The trademark.
Trademark
it and sell it.
Yes, sir.
We broke the numbers down. What, 2004?
Yeah.
If you go platinum. My conversation with Jeezy was this, Ron Hurd. If you go platinum on Def Jam and you got a 3-4 album deal and each one of your albums go platinum, that's 4 million records. If you get $1 million advance for each album, you're probably not going to get a royalty check. So you got 4 million. Just say you do get a royalty check and you get 5 million. But if you sell 1 million albums 4 or 5 times.
Right.
But if you sell 500,000 t-shirts at $50 a piece, if you sell hoodies in the fall for $100 a piece,
right.
You're going to make more money than you made on all those millions of records.
And you know what I was screaming?
No, I know what I'm going to tell you exactly what you told me.
House way.
You know what you told me?
Yeah.
You remember what you told me?
Man,
Hov finna hook me up with them. I'm finna get my clothing line.
Yeah, 8732.
I'm like, Young, listen, man. The t-shirt is the most profitable item in the clothing business.
Yeah, you said that.
But we're gonna do it.
But still though, we're gonna double back.
Christmas is on for the snowman, yeah, baby.
We're gonna double back.
But this book is out right now. Man, Trap Star, Def Jam, Bad Boy.
Yes, sir.
Trap Star is born.
My price is my price.
Branding 101.
Yeah.
The greatest show on earth.
Loyalty in the world is a lifestyle.
Yeah.
A few chapters.
Yeah, you're going to have to write a whole nother book about that.
Yes, sir.
That's a whole nother book. But some of the things that you really talked about in the book, man, give me some of the most touching lines, sentences, paragraphs, That really means so much to you in the
right.
Book.
I mean, well, really, you know, just coming to grips with Shakir's passing. You know what I mean? Because when it went down in real time, I don't think I was in the right place. But writing the book, you know, I was able to get in the space where I was able to accept it, and then just understand, you know, that it's okay to grieve and go through the motions of what happened. And there was a lot of stuff in the book that was therapeutic like that. It was like incidents that would happen, and I didn't deal with them then. So when I was writing the book, they all just came back. And it just was real moments. But I would say, if anything, you know, is knowing that it's never too late. You know what I'm saying? And every time you lose, you know, you learn.
It's a lesson.
Yeah, it's a lesson. Yeah, a big one, though.
Yeah, you can You can take it there, you know, with all the gossip in the phone calls and guess what happened, guess what he did, guess what she did. Or you can talk to the people who can really help you move forward and move understand the adversity of what you went through.
Yeah, and the real thing is like all the gems are in the losses. You know, if somebody came in here right now and asked you what mistakes you made and they wanted to be where you at in your career at some point, you can sit there and tell them with a straight face, this is where I messed up at, this is where I regret, and this is what happened, because you learned your lesson. But that's why you still been here for as long as you have.
Well, you have to understand that it's not just the journey is bigger than the destination.
For sure.
You know, people don't pay you to come speak about how much money you got,
right,
how big a house you live in, how many cars you got, how many watches you got.
Right.
They pay you to come talk about
the journey,
what you had to do to achieve your achievements and to get where you to accomplish what you did, how it all came together. That's where the bag is, and the bag is in that, because that's the real part. Like I was mentioning to you last night, that I really wanted to make sure people understand in this whole thing that we do, that once you get to a level, once you achieve a certain level of success, that don't mean that you're perfect.
No.
You know what I'm saying? Real is not perfect.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
We just want progress. We don't want perfection.
Well, everybody wants perfection.
Right.
They want to look at people who've made it and people who've accomplished this and did that as being perfect. That's why it's so easy for social media to tear people down, because that's the expectations.
Right.
The expectations is the number one killer in the black community.
Yeah, I mean, but for me, you know, I just think even just opening up and talking about a lot of the things that went on when people thought I was at the top of my game, you know, I was really going through the most. I was really going through the most when Trapper died and Thug Motivation was coming out. But people would see me out and think like, oh, man, he living a dream. You know, he riding around in Lamborghinis, he living life. And it's just like, you know, I was really crashing out. You feel what I'm saying? So to be able to share that now, and even like you said about last night with Tip, It felt good to laugh about things that we would have cried about then. You know what I'm saying? Even with him and myself. You know, we've been through, like Tip been through a lot, bro. You know, just like myself. But
I call Tip. I've been calling Tip like, he's like the our century's kind of Martin Luther King of hip hop, if that makes sense. It's like he's been through so much, but the adversity has made him who he is.
For sure. For sure. He got 9 lives too, man.
Tip got 9, that's it?
Yeah, might be 15.
9?
Yeah.
900. Man, I was at the what was the building on Piedmont? What was it called? The Civic Center. I was at the Civic Center. They were rehearsing for the BET Awards. I'm setting up for the live broadcast. I run past Tip backstage. What up? I'll see you in a few minutes. I'm about to go home and change. I get to the back, to the carpet, get set up. You know, we getting ready to broadcast. It's still early. It's about an hour early. Phone blowing up. Hey, man, Tip up the street at the public, man. They going, police up there. I'm like, I just saw him.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I got the call too, bro.
But for him to be able to go through all that,
right,
it's a testimony
for
a lot of people to witness, to understand that.
And saying that, you know, I talk about it in the book, you know, Tip was one of the first people that explained to me that I couldn't be in the streets and do music at the same time. Like, he was the one that pulled me to the side. I was like, hey, bro, you got talent. You know what I'm saying? He said, I believe you can do it. You know what I'm saying? He said, you could be big, but you're going to have to leave this where it's at. And he was talking about the streets. But imagine that, you know, you want to get to where he's at, and it's the guy that's coming to tell you. And that's because he had been through a lot anyway. And that's why even last night was so special, that we could sit down and, like, you know, laugh about this and tell stories, and everybody enjoyed it. But, I mean, man, at that point in time, boy, my nerves were so bad. I was so paranoid. You feel what I'm saying? So that's how I come back full circle, man. When you can sit back and laugh about some of the things that you thought would break you, that's how you know you're on the right path.
Made you strong.
Yeah.
Strong. Jesus in the studio, 414, you're in the 4 o'clock traffic. We're talking about the new book. You got to get it online. You can order it online.
Yes, sir.
The Audible book is available also. What websites are you really?
Amazon, Barnes & Nobles. Let's see here. Audible. What else? Really, everywhere books are sold. Everywhere books are sold is there.
More with Young Jeezy coming up to in the 4 o'clock traffic. It's V103. Young Jeezy in the studio.
Yes, yes, yes.
Talking Adversity for Sale.
You got to believe.
Adversity for Sale, the new book.
Yes, yes. Everywhere books are sold right now.
We need to read.
Believe that.
We need to read. Miss Rice, I see you calling me too. We need to read program. We still going crazy with that too, Jeezy. You might have to come out and do something with the book.
For sure.
Do a We Need to Read program for the kids. I started that, what, like 05?
Okay.
2005.
Okay.
I pay kids to read for them to understand how important it is if you read about the things that you're passionate about.
Right.
Most kids that read below grade level, people don't understand this. Most kids that read below grade level have to read the same thing 5 times to understand it is what they're reading, but they don't practice.
Comprehend it.
They can't comprehend.
Right.
Because they don't practice. Like, if you play basketball, football, you're on track, you play in the band, what do you have to do?
It's repetition.
You got to practice.
Yeah, it's repetition.
So if you don't practice reading and the teacher tell you to read these 10 pages in history, it's going to take you a long time because your comprehension level is so off. But if you read about what you like to do, you good. So
my reading is, and that's what got me back in the books. Somebody gave me a copy of Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill, and I was just like, I was in. Because reading wasn't fun in school, right? I wasn't getting, like, you know, social studies, whatever. I wasn't really walking away with nothing. But when I started back reading.
But see, the whole trick is you got to, if you read about what you like to do or what you're interested in your off time, when you assign something in class,
right,
it doesn't matter if you don't like it or not, because it don't take you as long to read it because you can comprehend.
Yeah, and I love that, bro. I love that. Congratulations about that, too. We need to read.
What are some of your biggest pieces that you read? Biggest books?
Biggest books right now, I'm reading The Everyday Hero Manifesto, and at the same time I'm reading The 5 AM Club. Those are my two favorite right now. But The Everyday Hero Manifesto, and of course I'm reading Adversity for Sale. Say that, but Everyday Hero Manifesto is like, that's it. Yeah.
So would you say, since you discovered the book that brought you back to the game, what's like some of the biggest lessons that you learned that are really helping you take your career forward, your business forward, right, just life forward, period?
I mean, when I learned reading Everyday Hero Manifesto and Think and Grow Rich, it just gave me the knowledge that I was seeking to move forward, because it was a lot of things that I didn't understand, which inspired me to do Adversity for Sale, because it was so much knowledge in these books about life, right? And these skill sets that they was helping you with, you know, it went over into like business, relationships, people.
The knowledge.
The knowledge. It was there. And you can go back to it. That was a crazy thing. You know, if you sit down, you have a conversation with somebody, they might give you some game, but, you know, that's in passing. But with this book, you can go back to a chapter and you can just sit on that chapter for as long as you like.
You can digest
come back to it. Yeah, you can come back to it. And when I started to move forward in life, I started to realize, okay, well, they talked about this in chapter 6. Let me just go back and just dig into this a little bit more. And then I would learn things. And then, especially with my healing process, because I didn't know where to start. And then I started to understand, okay, first you got to start with taking care of yourself health-wise. Then I started to figure out that you had to take care of your mental health, right? And I didn't really know what anxiety and depression was, right? But now I'm learning that, oh, man, wow, before, up until the recession, I was depressed, you know what I'm saying? But I couldn't explain that to the homies because they'd be like, man, you get money, what you talking about, right? But I was dealing with so many other things. And then, like, nowadays, you know, I feel comfortable telling somebody, you know, I went through that, because I'm quite sure somebody out there right now going through the same thing, bro. They don't know where to turn, what to do, what to read, what to pick up. And I'm hoping that's what the book helps them with.
This will be their piece that they pick up.
For sure.
Be their first step.
Right, because they know that I can relate to them in the way that they're going through it. I don't know Napoleon Hill, but shout out to him. He gave me an award when I was at, his foundation gave me an award when I was at Good Morning America. But, you know, that book changed my life. You know what I'm saying? So I'm hoping my book changes somebody's life.
And get them to Napoleon Hill.
Damn right. Damn right. Yeah.
When was it in your career that you discovered that a lick really wasn't a lick?
I kind of discovered that early on, because I was running with my cousin and them, and they would just like hit licks and go hit the gambling house. That's what Will was talking about last night. I used to be in the gambling house on Mechanicville with my cousin. And that's what he was talking about last night. He remember when I was young. But it just kind of threw me off that they would hit these licks. You know, and then, you know, the next week they be trying to figure it out again. I didn't understand that. But I just started to notice that fast money go away fast. And if you didn't earn it, you tend to spend it a little more freely, right? And you're not thinking about what you're doing because you feel like you can get some more. But if you earn it, You're gonna be smart about how you spending your money because you had to work to get it.
Exactly, and you respect it more.
No, for sure.
How hard is it for you being so successful when everybody, not everybody, but some people around you think that you can actually give them enough money for them to be able to jump off their dream or jump off their project or them be financially stable by you just saying, okay, I'm about to give you this 5, 10, 15, 20, 30,000. How hard was it for you to make people understand that I can't give you enough money?
Right. I remember one thing I learned, you know, and it was a little later in the game, is that if you're giving somebody something, you're enabling them. You're not putting them in a position to continue to earn. And what I started doing, and you might think it's funny, you know, Tony Robbins is one of my good friends. He's do these Date with Destinies and all these things. So I just started giving people packages, you know, to go to these Tony Robbins
conferences.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Even the video ones, right?
The links.
Go listen to this. But these are packages. They cost money. You know what I'm saying? He looking out for me and I'm looking out for my people. But then when I'm looking online to see who all's on there, I see who's not on there. So that's somebody on there.
So you really don't want no money.
Right.
You just want me to give you some money. Yeah. But you don't understand. I can't give you enough money.
Right. And one thing my mama taught me, man, she told me never talk to anybody, but never talk to another man with your hand out. Never. And I don't think it took me so long to ask people for something, even favors. You know what I'm saying? It was just like, it was just one of those things. And I had people ask me all the time, why you ask me to do that? Why you ask me to post that? I'm like, nah, man, I ain't want to bother you. But now I understand that this is what people do for each other. It's called support. Right. I don't got to give you nothing. But I you know what? You got a project you working on. I'm going to show you some love because you my guy.
The internet is free.
Right.
Like, there's that. One of the biggest examples of that is Snoop Dogg. Snoop Dogg posts everything.
Yeah.
And he's probably got one of the biggest followings, but he ain't tripping on helping you out by just posting something.
Yeah, yeah. But you know, it's different too, because Snoop Dogg a real one, bro.
Super real.
Yeah, he's a real dude, dog. And the crazy thing, a lot of people don't understand, like, Snoop is very smart.
Oh, very?
Yeah, very smart. Like, he borderline brilliant. I don't think people know that about Snoop. Like, he's very smart.
Very.
Yeah. Might be all that stuff he's smoking, but you know.
Don't credit to that, because you're going to have another problem.
Right.
How crazy to you, though, because I know you probably figured this out, too. How crazy it when people ask you for money, like, to pay necessities, like, I need some money to pay my light bill, pay my rent, pay my car note.
Right.
And it's like, for me, I look at it like, well, if you ain't paid them people.
Right. Then how you going to pay me back?
I know you not going to pay me.
Well, I learned a long time ago that if I loan somebody something, I don't expect for it back.
Right.
I never even went into a situation.
Well, I graduated to that. So it was like, I'm just gonna give you this.
Yeah,
don't hit me with the, hey man, when I get this, I don't even need to hear all that.
Because one thing about it, if you give it to them, they know they just can't come right back and circle back.
Exactly.
Right. And I go back to my uncle giving me, you know, his last $20. By it being his last $20, it made me take it seriously. You know, and I flipped that a zillion times, you know what I'm saying, until I was able to get on. But I know it was his last money, right? And what I learned about people as well is that if you give them something, because everybody, one thing about it, when people know you got some motion, they got 30,000 business ideas, you know what I'm saying, and without a business plan.
Yep, just hallway talk.
Right.
But at the end of the business plan, guess what? Hey man, let me get a few dollars. You know, I need to I need to pay this whoop de whoop de whoop.
Right.
And I'll be like, hey, listen, your mortgage company can afford to lose your file and never send you another bill.
Mm.
But you want to borrow some money from me to pay them?
Right.
And they're gonna put you out next month anyway.
Well, let me say this though. Coming up, you know what I'm saying? I did take to that mentality because I was trying to look out for people because I came up like that. I came up looking out for my aunties, looking out for my grandma, looking out for my cousin. That's what I'm saying. But like, I took that into my real life. You see what I'm saying? And I'm like, yo, yeah, I got you, bro. Don't worry about it. But when I was at my lowest moment, I couldn't ask nobody for nothing.
Nathaniel.
Nothing, bro.
Who you going to ask?
That's what I'm trying to tell you.
Young Jeezy, Adversity for Sale is a new book. Go get the book. It's out right now. It's online too.
So.
Everywhere books are sold, online, Amazon, Audible,
Barnes and Noble.
Barnes and Nobles.
Yeah.
Get you a hard copy though. This the homie. Get the hard copy so you can have it at the crib. You're gonna bump into him one day. He gonna autograph it for you.
All that.
You can have a discussion with him about, you know, what affected you, what impacted you the most. What kind of just turned the light on for you.
Right, your favorite chapter, favorite quote, you know.
Last night, the bank, the conversation, if you was at the conversation last night, I know you had a ball with Jeezy and T.I.
Shout out to Tip, my brother, man.
You're in that 4 o'clock traffic, 4:35. Anybody help you with the book that you want to give a shout out to? Anybody?
I just want to give a shout out to my whole team, Agency 99, HarperCollins, Jan Miller, Ben, everybody that's been, just been a part of this. Allie, everybody that's been a part of this whole, you know, just this, my you know, my, it's crazy that I can add author onto entrepreneur, philanthropist, you know what I mean? Like all these things. And this is just a special moment, bro. Like this is different. This is a different feeling. I came from.
And
Def Jam as well. They've been running around. Look at Ron.
And for all the
Did
people,
I forget anybody's name?
For all the people who think real is perfect.
Yeah.
For all the people who think real is perfect. Young Jeezy in the building.
Yes,
B103.
Sir.